All right, guys, today we are finally going to be taking a look at this IglooHome smart lock. A lot of you have been asking me for this, and I think I understand why now after having played with this for the last week. This thing has been on back order, so it took me almost a month to get my hands on one, but finally did, took it apart, and yeah, you're going to be very, very pleasantly surprised, as I was. I put it back in the box because I found that quality many times is a combination of a lot of little attention to detail things, and packaging is included. So they really made, I mean, it's a quality package, very solid. Pop the little tongue out of there, flip it open. There's a little ribbon on here. I mean, they really make it easy to get access to it. That's what you find. It tells you a little thin booklet. You really don't need it, though. But it goes into some detail for, you know, those of us that are a little bit slow, how to download the app and things like that. If you want the owner's manual, you can scan this and it'll tell you all about the path. I didn't have to do that. This thing is so absolutely intuitive that you're going to be very surprised. The lock inside of here, there's the lock. I've already inserted the battery, but that's where the battery went. And then we have a security bit tool in order to change the battery. And we're going to cover all of that stuff. When we pop this dude out of here, very substantial lock. It's very heavy, nicely done. It's kind of a matte black finish. Very, very nice. All these little scratches and everything, that's all my fault. As I said, I've been trying to beat this thing for about the last week, and I have tried everything I can think of. I've tried shimming it from every possible angle with three different styles of shims. No luck whatsoever. I've tried using a very powerful fluctuating electromagnet. No luck at all trying to activate the actuator on the inside of here, from outside of the case. No luck. I tried a very powerful magnet. Nothing. I even mounted a bunch of little magnets on the end of a drill and spun them around real fast, you know, varying speeds. Nothing. As heavy as this is, I've got a feeling that the heavy case is probably shielding the electronics package on the inside of here. On the outside of it, you know, you got your keypad, obviously. There's a little opening. There are actually two openings. First one is here. So first question people usually ask is, well, what happens if the battery dies? And of course, I asked that myself. There is an internal capacitor that stores energy for a short while. So if you wait too long, the CR2 battery that comes with this lasts about a year. And if you go more than a year and the battery dies, there's a little contact on the bottom here. You pop that cover off. You basically touch a 9-volt battery to it for a short while, which will then charge up the internal capacitor. Then you can set the battery aside and you can key in your combination. No other openings, no other way to get access to the lock going through the bottom here. So pretty cool. And on the back, we have the battery cover for the CR2 battery that, as I said, comes with this. Now, here's something interesting. This is usually a huge point of weakness on these locks. So we have a little security bit in order to turn it. They give a security bit to you. So let's put it in there, and we've got to turn it counterclockwise about a quarter of a turn. Actually, I'm sorry, clockwise a quarter of a turn. Slide it in there, and it doesn't move. And that's because this is one of the few electronic locks I found where the battery cover is actually locked mechanically when the lock is closed. So very well thought out. And we'll experiment with it. There's a lot of different ways to open this. There is what's called a master pin number, which is 9 digits long, and that never changes. And then you can assign any number of different types of combinations. When we look at the software, I'll talk about that. In order to get in here, I've already set this up for today's date, which is the 18th of September. So I go 180920, press unlock. We should get a green light, and it will then pop open. Couple things to notice. We have rounded cutouts on the shackle, but they are not ball bearings. They are servo-controlled locking pawls on both sides. They are not spring-loaded, so again, you can't shim this thing open. Once you've got the lock open, there's a couple of neat features. First of all, we're going to be able to now open the battery compartment, and we just very easily turn it, pops off. It is sealed with a rubber gasket to prevent moisture from infiltrating. We find our battery, and I'm going to pull him out of there. And that's because there are four screws, which they are security bits. I don't know if you can make that out. I did open that, and it's just the plastic insulating cover. Behind that is nothing but a metal, basically a bathtub, to hold the battery in place. There's no way to get access to the internal part of the lock. Another interesting thing, again, because it has a programmable EEPROM, it's going to hold all of my code. So by taking that battery out, it doesn't really doesn't eliminate anything. It doesn't nullify any of the combinations. Another thing you notice is this little pin right here. And that's because this is one of the few locks that has a removable or replaceable shackle. So we just turn it upside down, do a little jiggling, the little pin will fall out, and now we can pop that shackle out. You can buy additional shackles. You can buy real long ones, oval-shaped ones, round ones, a lot of different shapes, and they all work exactly the same way. Just shove in the one you want, take your pin, slide it back in there, and there you go. That's how easy it is to change the shackle. Let's put this battery back in, and let's jump over to the software, and I'll show you how easy it is to download stuff. All right, let's try to merge a little technology here. I'm going to try to overlay my iPad screen over there so you can see what's happening on the screen, and then you can also see what's happening with the lock. When you download the app, this is what you'll find. It'll be the screen with the name of your lock. I've only got one lock, so only Lock Lab, which is the name of that's what I named this lock. He's the only one that appears. You'll see that icon in the middle telling me that the lock is locked, and it is. And if I push on the symbol of the lock, it will turn green, telling me that he's unlocked it. Now, here's the interesting thing about this. I can do that from anywhere on the planet Earth, as long as I have a wireless connection or a cell phone connection, a cellular connection. So if you are on the other side of the planet, you need access to my back gate, call me on the phone, I can actually unlock my lock remotely. The lock will log who opened it, how long you were in there, and what time you locked it. So I can confirm all that, and I'll show you that in just a moment. You've got to physically lock it, obviously. So you close it up, and then the icon on the screen will then indicate that you've got your lock secured once again. Obviously, we have combinations we can give. I can give all different types of access. So let's take a look at that. So on the bottom, you see the icon that says access. We flip over there, you see I have two accounts set up. One, as the owner, I have a master PIN, which is 9 digits long. I'm not going to show you that because I'm going to give this a lock away to somebody, and I don't want anybody to have the access code. But I've got another one called Demonstration. Now, Demonstration, I've just clicked it open, and it is the date. So it's the 18th of September 20, when you saw me when I punched that in, we get an open. There's a lot of different types of pins that you can assign to this lock, which I found really kind of cool. Let me click that open. I've assigned a permanent pin. That's my demonstration pin, and that lasts forever. I can assign a duration pin. So if you tell me you're going to be there at 3 o'clock, I can activate the lock to accept your PIN between the hours of, say, 5 till 3 and 10 after 3, if 3 o'clock is the magic number, leaving the duration of only 15 minutes. Or the duration can be anything you want it to be, 1 year, 5 years, whatever. You can have a recurring PIN, so it repeats, say, every Tuesday at 4 o'clock, say, for your dog walker. You can have a one-time PIN, so guys got to get access to your gas meter. You can send him a one-time PIN, and then after he's used it, relocks it, the PIN will never again work. Or I can generate a Bluetooth key, which I've already done, again, to remotely open this up if you call me to get access to it. So very, very cool. If you take a look at the logs on the next page, this again is a very cool feature because this tells me exactly what's going on with my lock. If somebody shakes my lock, gives it a little shock, it'll pop up on the log. And it also, everything that's happened, somebody opens it, somebody closes it. And more importantly, it tells me who it is. It tells me if somebody's messing with the lock. So look down here a little bit in the center. You can see I was just playing around. I punched in a bunch of random codes, just trying to create a log entry. I get 5 attempts. After 5 attempts, again, you can set it for no attempts, or for 1 attempt, or up to 10 attempts. Then it will auto-lock, and it auto-locks for about 10 minutes. You can change that time as well. You can have it disabled, or you can have it auto-lock for 1 minute, or as much as an hour, if that's what you want. So pretty flexible programming on this guy. It tells me who opened it, how long they were inside, and what time they relocked it. So very cool log mechanism. I think that's critical on these to know who's trying to get access. And then the last icon, of course, are the settings. If you want to change the name of the lock, if you want to update your firmware, any number of other administrative tasks, you take care of them on the settings. So very, very cool lock. I have no complaints with this. This is one of the very few electronic and Bluetooth smart locks that I actually approve of. I would not hesitate to use this. Now, bear in mind, it's only a $100 lock. This is not Fort Knox. The shackle measures 9mm or 3/8 inch, which is slightly larger than many of the other padlocks, but it still will yield to physical attacks, croppers, you know, probably die grinders, things like that. So, you know, C4, yeah, I get it. You know, thermite, all that stuff will get through it, but it's not Fort Knox. It's a $100 padlock. So for the price, I think you get a lot of convenience and you also get a lot of security. So I'd have to say I recommend this. I have no problems whatsoever with this lock. Anyway, this will be the giveaway this week. So if you'd like to register for the free giveaway, stick around. I'll tell you how to do it. Appreciate your time, guys. Stay safe. Stay legal. All you need to do is navigate to locklab.com, the tribal website, and scroll down in the middle of the page. You'll see all the giveaway buttons, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. But the one you're looking for is the weekend review giveaway, purple band. Just click on it. It'll take you to the registration page. Again, scroll to the bottom, put in a good email address. So if you win, I can get in touch with you, let you know. Put in a username, doesn't matter what it is, and click submit. When you're done, you'll get a green check mark confirming your entry. Thanks, guys.